Hello you guys, and welcome to Abundantly Minimal. My name is Sarah, and we're gonna switch it up a little bit today. My friend and fellow YouTuber, Vince Leah, actually tagged me in a 20 things about me, my favorite things tag, so I'll be answering those 20 get to know you questions today. The first question is, what is your middle name? My middle name is Catherine, named after some extended family members. The next question, what was your favorite subject in high school? I am a social studies teacher, so as one would expect, the answer is social studies slash history. The next question, what is your favorite drink? Now the boring answer that's probably the most truthful is water. I genuinely love water and always am drinking plenty of water because I love it so much. But if I had to choose something more fun and creative, I would either choose like a matcha latte or like a vegan milkshake or smoothie. So that's a wide range of beverages there, but they're all things that can be made in a blender. What is your favorite song right now? Well, currently at the time of filming this, I think I'm filming this about a week or two before I actually upload it. There's this song by Maroon 5 called Girls Like You, or Girl Like You. But there's actually, I don't really like that version that much, but because I do watch a lot of like YouTube channels that create music and covers and things, there's a guy named Alexander Stewart. He's younger, but I love his voice. And he did a cover of the Girl Like You song that I have been having on repeat a lot the last couple days. Have I participated in sports? Yes, when I was in high school, I was a track athlete, also a little bit in middle school too, and then I was a track coach for 3 years at my past school. But I also enjoy other non-team sport related activities such as swimming, as well as playing tennis. But those are more so just for fun. Next question, what is your favorite book? I read a lot when I was much younger, so like my younger self would say the Chronicles of Narnia and the Sisterhood of the Traveling Pants series. I really enjoyed those. My adult self hasn't really read that much in terms of like fiction books. I typically read nonfiction more these days. So a lot of the books I've read haven't necessarily been, you know, like, oh, this is a page turner, but like they've been really helpful. So whether it's food related, like cookbook kind of things, or business books, like those have been very helpful to me. It doesn't necessarily mean that they're like the best books I've ever read. Individual things can be very helpful in terms of like, oh, this book taught me about social media strategy, or this book taught me about green juice recipes. So it's like very specific things. So I'll stick with my first answers about like the high school books. But these days I mostly just read nonfiction. Next question, what is my favorite color? It is blue for sure. Next question, what is my favorite animal? This one's also tricky because I genuinely love all animals, but I think I would say either polar bears or penguins. Next question, what is my favorite perfume or cologne? I don't wear that stuff. I don't really have a favorite. Unfortunately, a lot of it's very artificial and toxic fragrance, but what I do enjoy are essential oils, and specifically we have a diffuser in our room, and my favorite scent to use in there is eucalyptus essential oil, which is very calming and I just love the smell of it. The next question, what's your favorite holiday? You might laugh at this answer, but it's 100% genuine. Earth Day is my favorite. I feel like it's exponentially more important than any other holiday that exists, and I wish people took it more seriously. But not just on Earth Day, but like every day. All of our choices. Have I ever been outside of the country? Yes, I have. I know recently there's been a lot of the travel photos and videos from our most recent trip. On our most recent trip, we were in 9 countries. We went to Iceland, Poland, Germany, Austria, Italy, Greece, China, Indonesia, Australia. So that was our most recent one, but total I have been to 20 countries, including the US. Do I speak any other languages? Yes, I do speak Spanish as well. And I actually, even though I mostly just talk about myself as a social studies teacher, technically I do teach Spanish during part of my day, but I do greatly prefer teaching social studies. So that's really why I mostly identify with that. And that's where I got my certification and my main training in. Do I have a favorite store? If I'm being honest, if we're just talking about stuff, it would be Goodwill or other thrift stores. I love those places so much. And these days, most of what I purchase, it either needs to be used or secondhand, or making sure it's an ethical purchase in other ways. So used shopping is definitely something I prefer a lot, but I also really enjoy grocery stores in general. What is my favorite restaurant? So I feel so privileged to have tried so many incredible vegan restaurants all around the world and the country. So it's really tough. If I had to choose a restaurant that I have in my area that I have easy access to, I'm not in a major big city, but there's places around. Chipotle is my favorite. My usual order there is to get a burrito bowl with brown rice, black beans, fajita veggies, and their sofritas, which is the tofu, and it's really good with guac, lettuce, and like the mild salsa. That's my typical order there. Jake and I usually go at least once or twice a month. It's definitely our favorite in this area. But if I had to choose like all-time favorites, I really can't give it justice because there's been so many amazing places. In the US for sure, we were on our road trip. One of the places we went to was Los Angeles, and there was a restaurant there called By Chloe. That food was incredible, but the thing is, like, I've had so much good vegan food in our travels that I wouldn't even really be able to give a fair shot. Like, just even on this last trip, there's probably like 10 to 15 places I'm thinking of that would be like that tier of food, but yeah, there's been a lot of good stuff out there. Did I like school when I was younger? Absolutely. I loved it always. I was the kid who'd cry on the last day of school because I was bummed out that the year was over. So I guess being a teacher is a really good fit for me. Who are some of my favorite YouTubers? I hate to do like a cop-out answer, but I really enjoy YouTube a lot in general, and there's such a huge range. Obviously, like, I'm subscribed to a lot of minimalism related channels just because it's interesting to see what other people are doing in the minimalism community there, and I've worked with a lot of them and collaborated with a lot of them, so that part's really cool. I do sometimes watch different like entertainment type content, so like some of the late night TV hosts, I'll watch individual clips here and there. I do enjoy a lot of vegan channels, so vegan related videos, food related videos. I watch a lot of business channels. I watch some teaching channels. I watch a lot of music channels. And so they've got new music come out, I watch that. So yeah, there's really a huge range. Next question was my favorite movie. In genre, my favorite movies are either documentaries or romantic comedies. One that is my favorite, and it didn't even do that well, like, it's kind of obscure. I don't think it's really a movie people talk about that much. It's definitely not like a classic movie, but for whatever reason, I loved it. The movie's called The Age of Adeline. It came out a couple years ago, and yeah, for whatever reason, I was so like hooked on it, I actually had to watch it again. Like, we had rented it, and I had to watch it multiple times. I really, in general, don't watch a movie more than once. Very, very few movies I actually watch more than once. And that was one of them I've watched 3 or 4 times now, so there you go. What is my favorite TV show? The Amazing Race is a really great show. It's not on that much anymore. It's always like, fingers crossed, like, hope they'll come back for another season. It's where pairs of people travel around the world and solve puzzles and that sort of thing. I used to think I could be on it, but then I realized how stressful it would be, so I decided that that wouldn't really be in my future. In addition to The Amazing Race, another favorite show of mine is the whole Bachelor franchise. I hate to admit it, but at the same time, it does bring me a lot of joy. Growing up, my mom, sister, and I, and my dad sometimes too, would watch it all together, and it's been very interesting to kind of watch it, you know, watch it when you're younger and then watch it now, obviously, after I have Jake in my life. So I think that I view it a little differently, and I laugh more at it now than I used to. Of course, there's been some seasons that we haven't really gotten into, but I do genuinely enjoy it a lot. So it is what it is. Do I have any siblings? I think I missed that when I was supposed to say it earlier. I do. I have an awesome sister named Elizabeth, but I call her Lizzie. Lastly, how tall am I? I am 5'7" tall. So that wraps up this 20 questions get to know me type video. So thank you, Vince, for challenging me to this tag, and I will actually link Vince's original video down below and his channel if you'd like to check it out. He's got a lot of great vegan recipes and healthy eating tips and ideas. So thank you guys so much for watching. If you'd like to check out any past videos, you can do so here, or you can click up here to subscribe to the channel. We'll see you guys next time. Bye.